Welcome to Sorry But Can I Ask, a conversation among Canadian paraswimmers answering questions from the swimming community.
For the blind or nearly blind, how do you navigate daily life without bungling up?
It's just adaptations. The same way some of the physical impairment might modify their start, I just kind of modify everything in life. So for me, a lot of my things are labeled in Braille. So like my microwave, my stove are all labeled in Braille, and that makes it just really easy to be independent with it. But it's just a lot of learned skills and a lot of, I guess, doing what's done before. Blindness is a field that kind of changes super quickly with technology, but also we use a lot of really old stuff, like the cane is a very kind of simple invention, but it does its job really well. The same with guide dogs. They've been training guide dogs since the 40s, so it's a lot of old techniques that have kind of been passed through generations, and they work, and we don't really change them. So I guess it's just a lot of adapting regular activities to kind of suiting a world with no vision, but at the same time, integrating yourself as well as you can into everyday life.
Do you find that you do sometimes bungle up?
Oh yeah, lots. I used to always just like have this little segment in my brain every day, like, what blind thing did we do today? There's just kind of little things that you'll not be super aware of, that you might have just misplaced this one thing, or thing happened yesterday where I was doing something on the computer and I couldn't figure out what was going on. But if I could look at the computer, I would have seen that like I unchecked one box that was ruining everything. So I think it's little things that you kind of can't see the big picture of. It's being blind requires you to be very focused on kind of single tasks and have a harder time looking at the bigger picture, because you can only kind of take in so much information auditorily or through your hands. There's a lot of information to be taken in, especially navigating. Like I was kind of saying, you can't see the bigger picture, so you need to kind of remember little pieces to kind of form that image.
In the case of a swimmer with a visual impairment, isn't it a pity that the desire to compete is a bit low because you can't see other players while competing?
I do this for a lot more than my competitors. Like, I love swimming, and I'm doing it for the sake of swimming, not for the sake of beating the guy next to me. Obviously, I want to beat the guy next to me, and obviously, if I finish a race and I didn't, I'm going to be slightly ticked off by it. But like at the same time, the need to see other swimmers is irrelevant in many ways. I feel like the passion for competing comes from, I think for me, a place of betterment of self, and of kind of pushing that internal limit. And that's kind of the beauty of swimming as an individual sport, is a lot of the inspiration to get in that pool every day is like, I have a time and I want to get faster and I want to work on that. I think it can be, it's very similar for the rest of the swimmers here with me, is that we go into a race not saying, hey, I want to come in first. I just want to get a PB, or I want to kind of achieve this thing. I think that's the most important part, is knowing why you're doing swimming. And that it's not just, I don't know, I want to beat the guy next to me. It's important, but that can wait for after the race to look at the scoreboard.
So Matt, having roomed with you, when can I finally pet your dog?
So you can pet Goku when the harness is off and when you ask me. And if I've given you permission previously, as long as you know the harness is off, you're good to go. And the harness can look slightly differently depending on what Goku's doing. So if Goku's just kind of relaxing around, I'll only keep on the harness body, which is the leather piece that you'll see kind of arching over his back and around his front. But if he's guiding at work, the harness handle is attached, and that's the long piece that kind of sticks off the end that I hold on to. But just because the harness handle is off doesn't mean that the harness is off is kind of the most important one, and then just kind of pay attention. If the whole harness is off, he's free game.
You might lose your dog.